Welcome. In this session, we will talk about developments in science and technology from CERN, LIGO to Hyperloop and many more. Now, there have been numerous developments that have been seen. It's very, very obvious that we won't be able to go into the minute details of each. But yes, the topics that we are covering are extremely, extremely important for your upcoming examination. So cover those topics in detail very well. All of those topics are available at Examrace Current Affairs. The first here is the changes in the definition of kilogram that has come up. So there has been a redefinition that has come up. Now the three most standard units which are taken are time, distance and the intensity or the brightness, where you have second, meter and candela as the basic units. You have the copies which have been circulated for the various units, and how they are defined, the basis of their definition is again very, very important. The next is how we are trying to reduce the wastage of pesticides. So GMO, which is glyceryl monooleate, is a natural wax similar to the extract of the sunflower oil. This has been developed by CSIR, and this reduces the spillage of pesticides and the wastage due to that. A very, very important part of the research by CSIR, and this residue, the pesticide residue, basically leaches into the ground, mixes with the water system and has a long-term consequence on human life. So to reduce that, how we can use GMO is one of the major developments that have been seen. The next is the joint initiative of CDP, the UN Global Compact and the World Resource Institute and World Wildlife Fund, where we are moving towards a transition of low carbon economy. Now you have 195 countries which have signed the Paris Agreement, and the India's commitment is to generate at least 40% of the electricity through non-fossil fuel sources. So slowly and gradually reducing the carbon emission intensity of the GDP by 33 to 35% by 2030 is again important. The next is fingerprinting face recognition of the data. Now this is a means through which crime and criminal tracking network system has been announced. We have discussed in detail in our class on national security, a very, very important initiative through which the CCTV footages, the newspaper photos, the web portals, through all those, fingerprinting and face recognition would be taken into account, and this verification would help recording the criminals and the non-criminals. You also have the automated finger identification system known as FACS, which would match the fingerprints currently. So you have nearly 4 crore fingerprints which are already in the database with the FBI. The next is green propellants. So ISRO has been developing it for rocket and satellites. What are the propellants based on? The fuel is GAP and the oxidizer is ADN. Very, very important. A direct question could be there, which is a fuel, which is an oxidizer. Then what are the projects which are, there are combinations of hydrogen peroxide, kerosene, liquid oxygen and liquid methane which are part of it. ISROENE, as the name it suggests, it is a rocket grade version of kerosene, which is alternative to hydrazine, which is a rocket fuel as of now. The next is CERN and the Large Hadron Collider. CERN is a European organization for nuclear research, for testing and understanding and finding the Higgs boson decay as a fundamental particle is one of the major studies of this particle study. So CERN's proposal under the discovery of Large Hadron Collider is again very, very important. Then upgradation of this, the focus on LIGO is again very, very important, which is Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. In 2005, gravitational waves are ripples in the space-time that was discovered, and there was the various physicists working for the same. Nobel Prize was awarded to the founders for those in 2017, and the explanation of LIGO becomes very, very important. The next is the discovery of fast radio burst. Now this is a site of repeating fast radio bursts from a distant galaxy that has been seen beyond the Milky Way. So how the observations were seen and recorded is important. Chime telescope is again important, which is located at the Dominion Radio Astrophysical Observatory under the National Research Council of Canada. The man-made radio frequency interference by the municipal and the federal regulations were taken into account. So the chime reports have been important, and the radio bursts at various frequencies have been seen. In India, we have seen Indianization of various technology. PRL, the Physical Research Laboratory at Ahmedabad, is the first to track the exoplanets. Exoplanets are much away from its star, so they are neither too hot nor too cold, but there are definite challenges to understand those. There is limited number of spectrographs that can measure the mass of exoplanets with a very high precision. So use of a spectrograph is again very important question that could be asked. So the recent suspected exoplanet, how long it has been under observation and its composition is again important. So mainly ice, iron and silicates followed by 30% gas is one of the compositions. INO project, which is a particle physics research project to study the subatomic neutrinos, is one of the major projects that has talked about the masses identification and the challenges that has seen. India's mission to space, which is Gaganyaan, where the first India's astronaut would be sent, and these would be after US, Russia and China. India would be the fourth nation in line. So how the re-entry and the recovery process would take place, the crew escape system, the life support system is again very, very important. The next is the environmental control and the life support system, how it would be maintained. ASAT, very, very important. We have covered a separate lecture on ASAT. This is the anti-satellite missile technology, and India is the fourth country to develop this technology. Aim to destroy the satellites owned by the enemies. Now, this was test launched under the Mission Shakti project, and then you have the various research findings for the same. The next is unusual rock formations which have been seen at Timbuktu. This is located in Anantapur district in Andhra Pradesh. This is a kind of radioquiet region, as it has been described, for the faint electromagnetic signals from the sky that have been seen. National Supercomputing Mission is India's mission where we are planning to build 70 supercomputers for academics, R&D, for innovation, science and technology. Now, supercomputers, you have Spinnaker machine, which is a spiking neural network architect which can complete nearly 200 million actions per second, and each of the chip has nearly 100 million transistors embedded on it. Now, the use is, it could be used to control a robot which is known as spawn bot, and then you have the functions which will be simulations of basal ganglia, which is the area which is affected during the Parkinson's disease. Param Shive is India's first supercomputer that was brought about with 833 teraflop capability, and this was built by IIT and BHU. Then you had Pratyush, which is used in meteorology, Tropical Meteorological Center, and Mihir, used at the National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasting. Both of them are used for weather monitoring. The next is by the CERC Cray, which is used by IASC Bangalore. So Pratyush, the specifications for Pratyush, the specifications for Mihir, and the computing facilities are important. Under the space, we have GSLV Mark 3, which is a heavy lift launch vehicle weighing 640 tons, and this would be used in the Gaganyaan as well. So again, the SLV F11, which is a geosynchronous satellite. So what is geosynchronous, what is geostationary, have been discussed in a separate lecture. So again, very, very important. GSAT 7A, again, an important topic. Chandrayaan mission. Now, under Chandrayaan, the rovers have been important and the landers are important. So, Vikram as the lander and Pragyan as the rover. So, two of the important things, and how it collaborated with Russian mission, which was Roscosmos. So, those are the important highlights for this. Definitely, Mangalyaan is very, very important topic. The next is HISIS, which is the first hyperspectral imaging satellite, which weighs around 380 kilograms and would be there for 5 years. It would have hyperspectral imaging of the space that would be provided from scene to scene and would be used for defense, agriculture and mineral findings. This was first tried out in Chandrayaan-1 mission. The next is the Draft Space Activities Bill 2017, which is applicable to each and every citizen and applicable to any of the space activities in India. The responsibility of the central government is to authorize the launch and operation of the space objects, develop professional and technical support for the same, ensure safety, and investigate any accidents, if any. Licensing, including the permission for the central government to inspect the space activities, is again important. The penalties have been given under this. So the aim of the bill, how Vikas engine would work, is again important. The next is the comet discovery. The Oumuamua comet, which is a Hawaiian meaning, where it means a messenger from afar arriving first, and that is the meaning of Oumuamua in Hawaii. Now this is where you have the comet discovery that has taken place. Now this comet is different to other comets because the dust is invisible, it is made of larger size grains, and the tail is made up of finer particles which are moving away from the nucleus. So it's very, very hard to detect the gas as a specific molecule. The liquid water lakes in Mars is again checked out by MARSIS, which is the advanced radar for subsurface and ionosphere sounding. There has been reasons why liquid surface have been found on the Mars, and this is again very, very important topic that you need to cover. Unnati, which is a unispace nanosatellite assembly and training by ISRO, is a building program, capacity building program aiming at nanosatellite development, conducted for 3 years in 3 batches. Yuvika is a program for young scientists and promoting girl child for training into space technology, space science, and this under this you would have 3 students from each of the state that would be selected from state board, CBSE and ICSE syllabus. Students who have just finished 9th and entering 10th would be part of it. Similarly, you have SATIC, which is the Science Technology Innovation Advisory Council. Now this, in interaction with PM, has nearly 21 members, which are mission oriented, working as special invitees and talking about the recent innovations and developments. The next is ITER, which is the International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor, and it's one of the world's largest experimental fusion facility, which is seen in the region of France. Again, it is the first industrial scale fusion reactor that is there. Very, very important. So those are some of the key highlights from Mars mission, Mangalyaan, Gaganyaan, talking about ASAT, anti-satellite missile technology that we have talked about, focusing on CERN, LEGO, and the comet, the Oumuamua comet that has been recently discovered, talking about exoplanets and the role of PRL. So those are some of the key highlights. We'll be continuing with science and technology, some of the major developments in the next section. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.